Thank you, Ilian. So, congratulations to each of you, to all of you, graduating class of 2018 D. Welcome to your friends, welcome to your family. Here today to actually welcome you in this important moment with all of you. Really take the time to celebrate, to enjoy this time together. It is a moment in your life you will always remember. Believe me, you were outstanding during this year, and you deserve this moment. Congratulations again. Et aussi, bravo Luc pour ton PhD, et bravo Alice pour ton barreau. My two kids. So, now, Bhutan, who among you is reading the press for Bhutan every day? Once a week. Once a month. Well. So, let's start again. Who have been once to Bhutan, the country of happiness? Okay, great. Much better, even though just few hands up. So, if you read the newspaper of Bhutan early this month, you will have learned that Essilor has partnered with the Bhutan royal family and the royal government of Bhutan to make Bhutan the first country in the world to eradicate poor vision. So why? Thank you for them. So every woman, every man, every child can see well and then have a better life. So together with the government of Bhutan, we will screen the eyes of every citizen depending on their needs. We will provide them prescription lenses, sunglasses, or reading glasses. With such simple solution, they will see well and enjoy life to its fullest. So those of you who are in business, you know what it means. It means we'll put in place an infrastructure to ensure that all the Bhutanese will have access to eye care. From the right business model to efficient supply chain across the really famously hard to reach country, we will build sustainable eye care. But we can't stop there. If you have read the newspaper, you also would have read that we are also partnering with the monastic body of Bhutan to raise awareness of seeing well, to educate everyone on the benefits of seeing well, to open their eyes and their mind on the fact that they can improve their lives thanks to better vision. So from a child's ability to see the blackboard or improving adults' profitability at work and at home, glasses at some point will help them and will help everyone on the planet to see more and to do more. But good vision is so closely linked to our well-being that once more, same in Bhutan, the royal government of Bhutan has decided to include it as an important part, actually, of their gross national happiness index, the philosophy of their government. So I see some of you smiling now at this stage, because why Hubert is talking about all this? Why Hubert is talking about the Bhutan and the happiness index? Why, as you said, an alumni MBI, this chairman, it seems, to a 50 billion plus million dollar company with actually 150,000 employees around the world. Why am I talking to you today about happiness and life improvement? Why I am not talking to you about power, success, or career management? One reason, and Ilian gave you that reason, because we want each of you to have impact. To have impact on your corporation, have impact on your neighborhood, have impact on your society, have impact on the world. We want each of you to have impact, to make an impact on the world. You choose, you decide, but we want you to make impact. As businesswomen and men, make business a force for good by doing what you like to do. And I am sure this is what Iliani explained that to you, wanted for each of you and all of you when under his leadership, INSEAD has created the Institute for Business and Society. In fact, Urs, I joined Essilor exactly 30 years ago, end of December 1988, a few years after my MBA in Fontainebleau. And believe me, the first 20 years, I have done all the type of job you can imagine in a corporation like us, from finance, production, marketing, sales, and a bit everywhere in the world. We have sold billions, tens of billions of lenses, of sunglasses, of frames in every country around the world. We have built a very strong and performing corporation with a yearly average return for shareholders of 18% over 45 years, 80% per year. All of us, we were extremely happy, of course, to provide better vision to our clients. Also very happy with all the philanthropic works we were doing along the way. A week vision camp in Costa Rica, another week the year after in Venezuela or in Thailand. Working with all organizations, many foundations everywhere in the world. Great results, great job. Great feeling. But step by step, 10 years ago, with my team, we connected the dots. We had an epiphany, and we realized the obvious. Poor vision was still the biggest handicap of the world. With 2.5 billion people living with undercorrected, meaning one out of three people can't see the world clearly. Many of them being excluded because of their unaddressed handicap. Yes, of course, we were doing business with 1.8 billion people, improving their life, improving their sight. Yes, we were developing an outstanding business, but we had almost forgotten one third of the total population. We had almost forgotten our mission, the meaning of it, the ultimate goal, the impact. And when we started to look at our businesses from an impact point of view, from a business for good angle, when we remembered that business exists to serve society, then suddenly everything became clear. And suddenly we had a clear mind. what we were doing with 1.8 billion customers, we had to do it for everyone and everywhere. We had one purpose, one mission, one objective: eradicate poor vision from the world. Having a good vision is a human right. It's a basic human right. So why in 2018, in 2015, billions of people are still suffering from uncorrected poor vision when, believe me, all products exist at every price point? All solutions exist today in the world. And this is with this mind that we have reorganized totally our corporation. This is with this mind that we have reorganized the corporation under three main models. The traditional business model, including the online activities, inclusive business models, and philanthropy. We had to find new ways to reach the 2.5 billion people living with undercorrected vision. 90% of them are living in developing countries, and they are facing four key challenges. The first one is awareness. Less than 1% of global health and development investment budgets are spent on vision care. Many people still don't know that they need a visual correction while all the solutions for them to see well. Access. There is a dramatic lack of access of eye care professionals in emerging countries. This world is missing hundreds of thousands of professionals and stores to fulfill the current needs. Access is one of the most challenging issues. It is the bottleneck of vision correction. Acceptance. In many cultures, glasses stigmatize people, and they risk to be considered as less able and excluded from their communities. So we have to work on education, self-esteem, in order to make sure that glasses are fully adopted. Affordability is the fourth one. Many of the 2.5 billion people without visual correction live with less than $8 a day, while everybody, everywhere, should be able to actually afford glasses they need. So, with all this in mind, how have we responded? First, we created a dedicated vision, reporting directly to me as CEO. I appointed Giant, who is here with us today, by the way, our chief mission officer. And he has attracted top talents from everywhere in the world, motivated by a passion for our purpose. This team has developed sustainable, inclusive business models adapted to local needs, to improve access and to improve awareness. Not only do these businesses provide vital vision care, but of course they create jobs everywhere. But it was not enough. We also looked at our product and developed basic quality glasses, high quality glasses, at a selling price less than $5. And those products are now developed in 45 countries around the world. We created the Vision Impact Institute, an independent organization to drive research and advocacy to improve the awareness of all the stakeholders on the social and economical impact of poor vision in the world. And we have partnered with local, a lot of locals, and large NGOs. And as you have seen, we are now partnering directly with governments or organizations like in India, in China, in France, and in Rwanda now for a few weeks. And yes, And yes, and you can imagine we had a lot of challenges. We had to convince our board of directors that our mission, our purpose, had to drive the strategy and not the opposite. We had to show all our shareholders that this new organization will create long-term value while at the same time not destroying short-term value. And we also had to rally all our colleagues to this mission and to this ambition, eradicating provision, to educate all traditional activities that also they are business for good. But every day we see our impact on the world. We see the people who, thanks of seeing well, can find a job, get a job, keep their job, contribute to their own communities, and then get back their own self-esteem. We see children who can participate to class for the first time, because now they can see the board thanks to their glasses. We have been able to achieve this as a corporation because we have reversed our traditional business paradigm. Because our mission, our purpose, to eradicate provision from the world is driving our strategy and not the opposite. Because we had a firm conviction that the fight against provision can be won if business and society join forces. And together, corporation with strong mission, with strong purpose, and actors of the civil society, government, NGOs, organizations, all of us together, we can have a great impact. When your mission is driving your strategy, believe me, everything becomes clear. Everything is much clearer. And in our case, we want a world where everyone can see well by 2050. This is our objective and our goal. So this means we have to develop product offering at every price point, put in place supply chains to connect the last mile, to reach what we call the unreachable in every corner of the world, and to invent financial models that can support the expansion of our product. When your mission drives your strategy, you look at the world from a totally different angle. You look at your own role in the society from a totally different angle. Then, managing your business as a force for good becomes clear and obvious. In a few weeks, you will go back to your job, or maybe you will start a new job. But remember, as Ilian said, the world needs leaders like you. Leaders who could have a positive impact on the society and the world. We need leaders who have a vision and a mission for this planet. You are all smart, you are all brilliant, you are all very powerful. Turning around a company, increasing sales, building a fantastic marketing plan, boosting profitability. Believe me, this is not complicated. Hundreds of thousands of MBAs are trained to do this. But with your INSEAD MBA, we want you to go a step beyond, to be different business leaders. We want you to champion business as a force for good. Again, I want to congratulate each of you for your hard work and your great achievement at INSEAD for getting your MBA. So bravo, bravo. Now, use it the right way. And as a final word, if there is only one thing that I would like each of you to remember from this graduation day and keep your mind off your life, define your mission, define your purpose, but make sure that this purpose and this mission is driving your strategy. Thank you very much.